Hello everyone, I am going to explain question number 11 from exercise 4.1. This question belongs from 11th class maths. In this question, a mathematical statement is given to us, and this mathematical statement we have to prove that it is true for all natural numbers, and we have to prove this with the help of principle of mathematical induction. So mainly the first I want to explain about principle of mathematical induction. There are three steps. If you are able to satisfy that three steps, then we can say that the mathematical statement is true for all the natural numbers. So the three steps are, first step is, we have to assume that the given mathematical statement we have to assume as Pn, and in first step for n equal to 1, we have to prove that P1 is true. And in the second step, we will assume that let for n equal to 1, n equal to k, the statement pk is true. And in third step, we have to prove that pk plus 1 is true when statement pk is true. So these are the three steps which we need to prove. The three steps are, first step is, for n equal to 1, we have to bring the mathematical statement is true. And then in second step, we have to assume that for n equal to k, the statement, given statement is true. In second step, you not have to prove anything. You only have to assume that the statement pk is true. Then in third step, with the help of pk statement, we have to bring pk plus 1 is also true. So if we are able to satisfy these three conditions, then we can say that the given mathematical statement is true for all n belongs to capital N, means all the natural numbers. So we'll start it. First we'll assume this given mathematical statement as Pn. So we'll write here Pn statement is defined as, so the statement Pn is defined as 1 divided by 1 dot 2 dot 3 plus 1 divided by 2 dot, dots means here they are in multiplication, plus 1 divided by 3 dot 4 dot 5 plus it's extended up to 1 upon n, n plus 1, then n plus 2, and is equal to n plus 3 whole divided by 4, n plus 1, then n plus 2. So this is our statement Pn. Now in step 1, we have to prove that for n equal to 1, the statement is true. So step 1, on substituting n equal to 1 in left hand side of statement Pn, we get left hand side of P1, because instead of n we are substituting 1, so instead of Pn it's going to be P1 means only you have to take first term, because if Pn is there, then we have to take all the n terms. So if you have here 1, then you have to take only first term. If you have here, instead of n, if you have 2 here, then you have to take first 2 terms. So just now here we have 1, so we are going to take only the first term, that is 1 upon 1 dot 2 dot 3, that is they are in multiplication. So it's going to be 1 upon 1 dot 2 dot 3, that is 1 upon, so it's going to be 6. In the same way, we are going to get the right hand side. Similarly, right hand side of P1 is equal to, so students, in the right hand side of PN statement, wherever N is there, that N we are going to replace by 1. So we are going to get here 1 bracket 1 plus 3, then 4 bracket 1 plus 1, then bracket 1 plus 2. So it's going to be 1 multiplied by 4, 4 divided by 4, multiplied by 2, multiplied by 3. So students, here you can see that this 4 and this 4 will cancel. So we will get only 6. So it's going to be 1 upon 6. So we can see that the left hand side and right hand side are same. So we will write here left hand side of P1 is same with right hand side of P1. Then we will write down. So this statement is true for n equal to 1. So we will write here thus 4 n equal to 1 statement PN is true. Now we will prove for the step second. In step second, we will assume let 4 n equal to k statement PK is true. So this is our assumption, and where, what is k, we have to mention where k is any positive integer. Now so first we are going to write down here PK statement. So in the wherever we have PN statement, that wherever we have N, that N we are going to replace by K. So we'll obtain, so for question this I am writing here 1 divided by 1.2.3 plus 1 divided by 2.3.4 plus 1 divided by 3.4.5 plus it's extended up to 1 divided by, now in this term we have n, wherever n we have, that n we are going to replace by k. So k, then k plus 1, k plus 2, then in the right hand side also we have n. You can check your PN statement or you can check the question in the book. Wherever n is there, and you just remove, and instead of n just write down k. So the right hand side you will obtain as k, then k plus 3, 4 bracket k plus 1, then bracket k plus 2. So this we have to assume as equation 1. So this is our assumption that the statement pk is true. Now we are going to move to the third step of same question. In third step we are going to prove that PK plus 1 statement is true. So we will write here, we have to prove statement PK plus 1 is true whenever statement PK is true. So from equation 1 we have, so students, here what we have to do is, with the help of this PK statement we need to bring PK plus 1 is true. So first we will write down this PK statement as it is, and from this we will convert this equation, PK equation, to the PK plus 1. So I am writing the equation, it is going to be 1 divided by 1.2.3 plus 1 upon 2.3.4 plus 1 upon 3.4.5 plus its extended up to 1 divided by k, then k plus 1, k plus 2 is equal to k, k plus 3, then whole divided by 4, k plus 1 and k plus 2. Now in this equation, it's the equation of statement pk. So when we have k here, that time here we have k. So if we want to convert the statement to k plus 1, so wherever you have k, you have to bring the k plus 1 statement. So that extra term you need here. So we are going to add one extra term in the left side also and in the right side also. Now what extra term? For that, in the last term of pk statement, wherever you have k, replace it by k plus 1. So whatever your result you will obtain, that result you have to add in this equation in left side also and as well as in the right side also. So we write here on adding. Now what I am going to do is, here wherever we have k, I am writing only k plus 1. So that result we will add in the both the sides. So I am going to do here on adding k plus 1, then big bracket, k plus 1 plus 1, then again k plus 1 plus 2. So just check what I have done here. Instead of this k, I wrote here k plus 1, and instead of this k also I wrote here k plus 1. So I will put this in the small bracket, then it will be clear to you that instead of this k, I wrote here k plus 1, and in the same way instead of this k, I wrote here k plus 1. So when we simplify it, here this plus 1 and plus 1 will add, so we will get here k plus 2, and here we will get k plus 3. So when we simplify it, we are going to get here 1 divided by k plus 1, k plus 2 and k plus 3. So this term, whatever term we obtained after analysis, we obtained this, and when we simplified, we obtained 1 upon 3 brackets we obtained. Now this term you have to add in the left side also and in the right side also in the pk statement. So when we will do this, we will get this equation. In above equation, so we are going to get here, so it will converge to k plus 1 statement. So we will write here 1 divided by 1 dot 2 dot 3 plus 1 divided by 2 dot 3 dot 4 plus 1 divided by 3 dot 4 dot 5 plus it's extended up to 1 upon k, then k plus 1, then k plus 2. Now here we are going to add one more extra term, that is k bracket k plus 2 and bracket. So we have the length of space here, so it's going to be here k, then k plus 1, k plus 2 and k plus 3. So I am going to adjust it right, anyhow it's not able to adjust. So the additional term which we are going to add in both the sides is k plus 1, then k plus 2 and k plus 3. So this is our left hand side of this above statement. So what I have done is, in the left hand side I added this term in the left hand side as well as in the right side also. So first I am going to write down the right side, then I will add it. So the right hand side is going to be k, k plus 3, whole divided by 4, k plus 1 and then k plus 2. So in this side also we have to add the same term. So it's going to be plus 1 upon k plus 1, then k plus 2 and bracket k plus 3. Now what we have to do is, in the right side we have two terms. This is our first term and this is our second term. And these two terms we have to add. So we need to take the LCM of the denominator, and left side we have to keep as it is. So here after equal to, I am going to solve only the right hand side. Do not have to do any change in the left hand side. So it's going to be like this. After equal to, I am just operating only the right hand side. So I am taking the LCM of the denominator. So when we take the LCM of the denominator, we get 4. And all the different brackets just write down. So k plus 1, then bracket k plus 2, and then bracket k plus 3. So when you will observe carefully, in the denominator, first 4 is alone, so 4 will come. Here also k plus 1 and here also k plus 1. So from that only once you just write down, and from k plus 2 also only write down once, and k plus 3 is different, so write that also. So like this, just take the LCM. After taking LCM, LCM is divided by the denominator. So when you will divide it by denominator, you are remain with only k plus 3. So when you will multiply here, you will get here k bracket k plus 3 square. So the numerator of first fraction will give us k bracket k plus 3 whole square plus. Now again this denominator, we have to divide by the LCM, we have to divide by the denominator. So when you will divide it, you will get here 4, and then only we will get only 4, because all these three brackets are present in the denominator of second fraction. So we will get here only 4. So 4 into 1 is 4. So we write here 4. Now what we have to do is, we don't have to do anything in the denominator, only numerator we will solve. So first we will open it by a plus b whole square, this bracket. So we will get here 4 bracket k plus 1, k plus 2, and then k plus 3 as it is. And I am going to open the bracket by a plus b whole square, that will give us k square plus 6k plus 9 plus 4. So I hope it's clear to you. I opened this bracket by using a plus b whole square. Now further I am going to open it to the small bracket. So I will multiply these three terms by k, that will give us denominator as it is, it is 4 bracket k plus 1 bracket k plus 2 and then bracket k plus 3 as it is. When we open here, we will get k cube plus 6 k square plus 9 k plus 4. Now here what we have to do is, we are going to separate some terms in the numerator so that we can get some brackets as it is in the numerator, which are same like the denominator brackets. For that, carefully we have to split the numerator. So first this 6k square I am going to write as 2 plus 4, and this 9 we are going to write as 1 plus 8. So like this we are going to separate them. This k cube as it is, 6k square I am going to write as 2k square plus 4k square, and this 9 we are going to write down as 1k plus 8k and then 4 as it is. So I hope it's clear to you. So this 6k square we split it as 2 plus 4, and this 9 we split it as 1 plus 8. Now further we have to make the groups of 3 numbers. So again the denominator as it is, it is 4 bracket k plus 1, then k plus 2, and then k plus 3 as it is. So k cube plus 2k square and plus 1k in the one group, and remaining three terms, that is 4k square plus 8k plus 4 in the second group. So these three terms is going to be my first group, and these three terms are going to be the second group. So in this you can see k is common, and in this group 4 is common. So we take common and there is no change in the denominator. So denominator we'll write down again as it is 4 bracket k plus 1 bracket k plus 2 and bracket k plus 3. We'll take here k common, so we are remaining with k square plus 2k plus 1, and here we'll take 4 common, so we are remaining with k square plus 2k plus 1. Now you can see that whatever brackets we achieved, that are same, so that also we can take common. And moreover, this bracket is the formula of k plus 1 whole square. So it is also k plus 1 whole square, and this one is also k plus 1 whole square. So that we will write down here. So 4, then k plus 1. K plus 2, k plus 3, we take k square plus 2k plus 1 common, so we are remain with k plus 4. So from here I took common, this bracket I took common, so from here k remains and from here 4 remains. Now this bracket is actually k plus 1 whole square, because it's a square, 1 square and then 2ab, so it is k plus 1 whole square. So we will write it as k plus 1 whole square, then k plus 4 and down 4, k plus 1, k plus 2 and then k plus 3. So you can see that this bracket will cancel, so we are remained with only k plus 1. So that is our last step, but we have to convert the answer in the right hand side of PN statement. So first we will see that what is the right hand side of statement PN. For that we need to see the question's right hand side. So you can check your right hand side in the question. PN's right hand side is, I am writing from the question, the right hand side is N, then N plus 3 whole divided by 4 N plus 1 and then n plus 2. So this is our right hand side of the question. So in this format we have to bring it. So what we have to do is, because here instead of n we have k plus 1, so this n also we have to replace as k plus 1. So we already have here k plus 1, so this k plus 1 we are not going to change, this k plus 1 as it is. And here instead of k plus 4, we will write it as k plus 1 plus 3, then big bracket close. So numerator is adjusted. Just see here students, here we have n, then bracket n plus 3. So instead of n, what we need to do, k plus 1. So k plus 1 already we have. Now here instead of k plus 4, we need it in the form of k plus 1 plus 3. So I splitted this 4 as 1 plus 3. Now in down, 4 we want as it is, so we will keep this 4 as it is. And here we have n plus 1, so instead of n, if we replace k plus 1, it is going to be of this format 4 and then big bracket k plus 1 plus 1 and again big bracket k plus 1 plus 2. So you can see that the right hand side is adjusted what we want, because here is n plus 2 and here also we got as k plus 1 plus 2. So this right hand side we successfully converted in the form of right hand side of k plus 1, which we cross checked by the right hand side of PN statement. So we can say that pk plus 1 is 2. So we will write down here, thus pk plus 1 statement is true whenever statement pk is true. So we will write here, hence by principle of mathematical induction, statement PN is true for all natural numbers. So this question is completed. So students, in this question the statement pk to bring is a little bit difficult, so be carefully, just do it, and in the same way you can try the remaining questions. Further, if you have any problem, you just write in the comment box so that I can clear out your doubts. Thank you.